Hello everyone. In last video, we saw about data communication as well as we saw categories of networks and also internet, etc. and protocols. So in this video, we'll be studying about different types of signal. What is this signal? What is the importance and different types of signal and what are the different properties of signal? So any idea what are these signals? Yes? Why we want signal in computer network? Yes? We are learning computer network. You might be thinking why we require this signals here. We are not ENC students. So any idea why we require signals? Think for a minute. Yes, because our data, which is in the form of bits, that is 1 and 0, cannot transmit in the wires. So already existing wires are there. You sometimes to transmit the data, we use existing telephone system or any other existing cable TV thing also we use. So their data cannot be transmitted in the form of ones and zeros. Data has to be converted into signals. So what are the, so it will be converted into something called electromagnetic signal so that it can travel through the transmission medium, either wireless or wired. So wire means some wires will be there. So to transmit the data, which is in the form of ones and zeros, you have to convert it into signals. So signal can be your analog signal like a sine wave or a digital signal, which will have only discrete value. So let's see about this in more detail. So in this video, you'll be studying about two types of signal, that is analog and data signal. And again, you'll be seeing what is this periodic signal, what is this non-periodic signal, what is the sine wave, the most common signal we use, then what the different properties of signal like phase, wavelength, digital signals, bit rate, bit length, etc. So let's start. So what is data and signal? So any idea what is data? You know, data is nothing but small piece of information. So when we are considering computer science, so how, what will be the data? Data will be in the form of bits of ones and zeros, but those cannot travel in your wires. So for the data to be transmitted, you have to convert it into the form of electromagnetic signals. Again, these signals are of two types. So one is analog, another is digital. So we'll see an example what is analog and what is digital signal. So if you consider analog, you can consider a sine wave. So as you can see, it has discrete values. So different continuous values, if it has, that will become analog. If you are having digital signal, it will be discrete. That is, it will have only two or some set of values. So for example, maybe it has 0 and 1s. So if you consider a axis, so 0 in the sense this, then high, then low again. So this is difference between digital and analog. That is, it will have continuous values in analog, whereas in digital you will have only two values, that is 0 and 1, or sometimes some fixed value. So it is called discrete also. So what next? That is, your data has to be converted into signals, and signals can be analog or digital. We have here one example is that, that is, if we consider a photograph. Okay, a photograph, if you want to transmit, so you, that photograph will be in the form of some pixels. Again, pixels will be in the form of zeros and ones. So when you are transmitting it via wire, you have to convert it into signal so that it will, because transmission media work by conducting energy. These signals will have some energy and some range, so it will go through those physical paths. So if now let's say about data, again, has your signal, your data can be analog or digital. Okay, analog data is nothing but it will have continuous values, whereas digital data will have only discrete values. So for analog data, we have an example, that is voice. Now I'm speaking, my voice has continuous value. It is transmitted in the air and it is going in the form of analog wave. And it can be captured. Now how I am capturing via my microphone, and it is converted, and it can be converted. This analog data is converted again. So analog data or digital data has to be converted in something called signals. So these is converted into signals or sampled. And digital data will have discrete state. More often you have seen in your D lab. So it will have only two values, that is 0 or 1. Sometimes some other, but it will have fixed value. It will not have continuous. It will vary around some fixed values. So that is, for example, data stored in computer memory in the form of zeros and ones. And they can be converted into digital signal or modulated into analog signal for transmission in the medium. So next, see about signal. Just now we saw data. Data can be analog and digital. Analog data will have a fixed continuous value. Digital will have discrete value. Now this signal. Signals are nothing but electromagnetic signals. It can be also analog or digital. So can you see? There is an example on the screen. So analog data will have continuous value. Here one value, here one. It is varying around so many points, so many values are there. And it is so this x and this is x axis where time is there, y axis is value. So continuously it is varying. Whereas that's what analog signal can have infinite number of values in a range. So you can see so many values, we cannot count also, so many infinite values are there. Whereas in digital, this you have only in this you can see 0 and 1, 2 only. So here it is 0, then it is moving to high. Again it is coming, so it is staying through high. Again it is coming down. So only two values are there, here 1, here 1. So same way below also, only 0 and minus 1. So in digital value, you have limit, digital signal, you have limited values. So it can be 0, 1 or something else, but here it is, so it can be 0 and plus 5 or something. So fixed value will be there. But in analog, there will be continuous values like this. That is the difference. Hope you have understood with data and signal. Now pause the video and write all the points discussed. Now let's begin with next different types of signal, that is periodic and non-periodic signal. So both analog and digital signal can take two parts, that is periodic and non-periodic. So periodic signal means it follows a pattern for a given time. Say in one given time t, it follows a pattern. Every time it repeats a pattern, one cycle will have one period. Whereas non-periodic will not be having same pattern. So we'll see an example on that. So if we see a periodic signal, and this is my x and y axis. So periodic signal means it will repeat a pattern. Maybe this is my one time period, or like this, one signal like this. Then again, so it is my one time period t. Then again it repeats the same pattern. My this are not even. So if I consider here. Yeah, so if I start with this signal, that is, this is in my time t, then next again same thing will be repeated. So again it will be same. So this is an example of periodic signal. If I see non-periodic signal, it will not repeat. Maybe it is like this first, then this is for t, then for 2t it might be something like this. So signals are not uniform. See here, first signal and first signal and second signal are not matching, but here a pattern is repeating. So if pattern repeats, it is called periodic signal. Whereas if pattern doesn't repeat, it is called non-periodic signal. So a periodic signal completes a pattern within a measurable time frame called period. Just now I told you t, right? T is nothing but a time period called period. So your pattern repeats, as you saw in periodic signal, two sine waves were there. First sine wave, and again it repeats the sine wave. And the completion of one full pattern is called cycle. So one in that T, one signal was there, that is called cycle, then again next cycle. Whereas non-periodic, we saw one more example just now. Non-periodic will not follow the same pattern or cycle. Okay, so again your analog signal and digital signal can be periodic or non-periodic. Okay, in data communication, we commonly in your data communication subject, we use periodic signal but analog. So periodic is nothing but it exhibits the pattern, whereas analog signal is something which doesn't have continuous value. You can have periodic digital signal also, but we use periodic analog signal because they use less bandwidth. We have to conserve our wires should not be overutilized. We should see about efficiency also. It should not be over occupied. So for less band, since this periodic analog signal uses less this bandwidth, we use this signal here. Let's do an activity on periodic and non-periodic signal. So I'll give you some signals. So identify which is periodic signal, which is non-periodic. Again, identify which is analog signal, which is digital signal. So we'll see some examples now. So solve this. Write down in your books which is periodic, which is non-periodic, and also analog or digital. So which is periodic digital, which is periodic analog. So now let's continue. Again, your periodic and non-periodic signal can be analog or digital, but in our data communication we are using periodic analog signal because they use less bandwidth. Periodic means it repeats the pattern. Analog means it has continuous values. If it was digital, only limited values, and if it was non-periodic, any pattern it would repeat. Here the pattern is same. So again, your periodic signal are classified into two types, simple and composite. Simple signal means a single signal will be there, but composite are formed up with many simple signals. So your simple periodic signal is also known as sine wave, and it can since your sine wave is a simple periodic signal, it cannot be divided into simple single signal, whereas composite signal are made up of many simple signals, so it can be divided into many types. Again, a composite periodic analog signal is composite of multiple sine waves. So periodic signal are two types, simple and composite. Simple in the sense only one signal will be there, simple one signal. Composite means it is made up of many simple signals. So this is one example of simple signal. So you have only one signal. This is your sine wave, because it is simple plus it is sine wave is nothing but it should be periodic analog signal. So usually we use this type of signal in your data communication. Okay. And your sine wave or your periodic analog signal has three parameters. One is peak amplitude, next is frequency, and phase. I think you have studied this in your D lab, electronics lab. So these are the three components of any sine wave. That is, one is peak amplitude, second is frequency, third is phase. So let's see what is peak amplitude now. So peak amplitude of a signal is absolute value of its highest intensity proportional to the energy it carries. That is, so in this example, if you see, what is the highest amplitude? What is the highest value? This side is negative, this side is positive. So highest value is nothing but this one, topmost value. So this is your peak amplitude. For electric signal, peak amplitude is measured in using a unit called volts. So there is an example. So identify peak amplitude. So peak amplitude is nothing but highest value of your signal. So highest value here, if you see this signal, this down axis is negative value. This is your highest value. And next, if you consider in this, this is your highest value. So that is nothing but peak amplitude, that the highest value of a signal. So this is one axis, this is your time axis, this is your amplitude axis. So highest value is nothing but peak amplitude. Next is period and frequency. So period refers to amount of time in second a signal needs to complete one cycle. So since we are using this period will be only for a periodic signals, because it follows a pattern. So your one pattern, that is, it is completes in one cycle, And that amount of time, just in the starting of the video, I drew one diagram and wrote T2T, right? So those, that is nothing but period. It refers to the amount of time and it is measured in second. A signal needs to complete a one cycle. And so next we have frequency. Again, this period and frequency are related. So frequency is inverse of period. So if I tell period, I can find out frequency. If I have frequency, I can find the period, because if you consider P as period, it is equal to 1 by frequency. So it refers to number of periods in 1 second. So period is inverse of frequency and frequency is inverse of period. So you can use this formula. So if F is frequency, T is period, F equal to 1 by T. Or if you consider period, it is equal to 1 by F. So frequency and period are inverse of each other, and frequency is measured in seconds, whereas period is measured in second, frequency is measured in hertz. Okay, so if we will see one example. So what is period? Period is nothing but time taken to complete one cycle. So if you take time as T, that is, they have taken time as 1s, so one cycle is completing in 1 by 12, that is because frequency is 12 hertz and each is inverse of each other. So one cycle completes in one period, and here it is 1 by 12 second because frequency is 12 hertz. Here frequency is 6 hertz, so your period will be inverse of that, 1 by 6 second. Your period is measured in second, whereas frequency is measured in hertz. So this is the two examples. Hope you have understood the three characteristics of a periodic analog signal. Periodic analog signal is also known as sine wave. So in that we have three parameters. One is amplitude, that is highest value of your signal. Then comes period and frequency. It is, period is nothing but time taken to complete one cycle, and frequency is inverse of same. Next, characteristic of a sine wave is phase. It describes the position of waveform related to the time zero. So you have x axis and y axis, you have time zero. So we related to that. If it starts with zero, there is no phase difference. Otherwise, how much there is, it will start late, that is a lag, and it is measured in degrees or radians. So 360 degrees is equal to 2n radian, or 1 degree is equal to 2n by 360 radian. This is the unit to measure. So as you can see, so phase describes the position of waveform related to time zero. So there is a zero. So how much lag is there? It is, the signal is starting from zero only. So there is no phase difference. Phase difference is 0 degree here, whereas it is not starting from zero. Okay, zero is here, half signal is over. So 1/4 time is over. So your phase difference is 90 degree. Here at least half of the signal is only gone. So from zero only down part is standing. So it is called phase difference is 180 degree. So that is the, these are some of the example. That is, depending on where your signal starts with the respect to time zero, that is known as your position of waveform. Next terminology is wavelength. It binds the frequency or period of a simple sine wave to a propagation speed of medium. That is, what is the speed of the medium? It binds it to the period or frequency. So as you can see, there is a signal, and so they are also considering that propagation speed. So there is a formula on that. That is, wavelength equal to propagation speed into period. So period is time taken to complete one cycle, and how much propagation speed, what is the speed of the data traveling in the medium. Okay, so that is nothing but wavelength. So it is product of the speed of the transmission medium and how much time is taken for one cycle or one pattern. Okay. And if whenever period comes, their frequency also comes, because period is nothing but inverse of frequency. So you can write it as propagation speed divided by frequency. So hope you have understood about sine wave and also the different this characteristic of sine wave. Sine wave is nothing but periodic analog signal, and it has three characteristics: peak amplitude and period or frequency. Period comes, frequency also comes, then comes phase, and also wavelength also forms a very important role, as it will tell you the speed. So next we will see about digital signal. So digital signal, as I said, digital values will be discrete, so it can be 0 and 1, so any fixed value. So in digital signals, information can be represented by a 0 or 1 or positive voltage and 0 voltage also. So positive voltage can be encoded as 1, sometimes plus 5 and all, and there will be something called 0 voltage. And sometimes a digital signal can have more than 2 levels, but it should be discrete and fixed. So in this case, we can send more than 1 bit for each level. So there is one example here. So these are digital signal. So as you can see in this diagram, only 2 values it has, 0 and 1. Whereas in second diagram, we are sending 4 values, that is 2 values at a time. Okay. So it can have other value than 0 and 1s also. In the first diagram, 8 bits are sent in 1 second. In second, it is 16 bits. So if you have more than 2 values or 2 levels in digital signal, you can send more than 1 bit for each level. So here in the second diagram, 2 bits we are sending in each level. So 8 into, so 16 bits are there. Whereas in first, only 1 bit for each level. So it is 8 bits. So this is, first one is a digital signal with 2 levels. Second one is a digital signal with 4 levels. So next, let us see some of the characteristic of your digital signal. So bit rate. So bit rate is nothing but the number of bits sent in 1 second. So that is expressed in bit per second. That is how for analog signal you had peak amplitude, period, phase and all. Here we have some, for if it is digital signal, bits will come, because only this, it's some discrete values will be there, so bit will come. So we will calculate the digital signal using bit rate. So it is nothing but number of bits sent in 1 second is nothing but bit rate, and it is expressed by a value called bits per second. So here example is there, that is here bit rate of first signal is 8 bits are sent, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1 bit in 1 second. So 8 bits is sent in 1 second, so it is 8 bits per second. Here at each level 2 values are sent, so it is, the bit rate is 16 bit per second. So first one is digital signal with 2 levels, whereas second one is with 4 levels. Again, next comes bit length. How we had wavelength for sine wave or analog wave, here we have bit length. It is distance 1 bit occupies on a transmission medium. Again, how we had a formula for a wavelength, that is bit length equal to bit duration into propagation speed. It is same like your wavelength. Wavelength was equal to transmission speed of the this and into period. Here it comes bit duration. Okay. So some of the important question that might be asked on this. Okay. So these are the this data communication you had studied in first video only. Then comes in phase you have studied in this video, wavelength, bandwidth and throughput you will be studying in next videos. This, if they ask you this question, you have to write it with a diagram. And second question is, define the following, that is periodic signal. Just now I told periodic signal will be having something called continuous value, and you have to draw the diagram. Next comes non-periodic signal, that will have discrete value. Again, draw the diagram. Latency we'll see in next video. Jitter we saw in first video. And then comes bit rate, that is number of bits per second. So write all these answers in your assignment book. So the textbook I have referred for this is Data Communication and Networking using Horizon. Hope you have understood the concept in this video. In this video, we have just seen about signal and data and different type of signal, basically analog and digital, again types in that, periodic and non-periodic. Again, we have seen some characteristics of analog signal, some characteristics of digital signal. So also there is a quiz in the description box. Please take the quiz, and any doubts you have, please comment. Thank you. Take care.